That's not how you destroy a black hole, little kitty. That's an interesting question. Hey friends, we all know the destructive capacity of a black hole. But have you ever wondered if there is any way we could destroy it before it engulfs our solar system? Well, in today's episode, let us dig deep into this possibility and answer a world-saving question. Can you destroy a black hole? Zoom in! Black hole, it is an extremely dense object in the universe with a gravitational force so strong that it could absorb anything that comes near its event horizon. Yes, be it a star, an asteroid, or even a giant planet. Nothing can escape its strong pull, adding to the black hole's mass and expanding its radius in the process. There is no element in the world you could shoot inside the black hole to stop it from causing havoc. Not even another black hole. Yes, if two black holes come face to face by any chance, it won't absorb the other. Instead, the two will merge to form a supermassive black hole while releasing a bit of energy as gravitational wave. And because of its non-destructive capability, there might come a time in the future when the entire universe will be filled with black holes. So, it is essential to find a way to destroy or evaporate them before it's too late. But the vital question is there any way to do it? Well, as they say, where there's a will, there's a way. And that way is shown to us by none other than the great Stephen Hawking. Yes, in 1974, the late physicist Stephen Hawking proposed a theory that while black holes get bigger by eating material, they also slowly get smaller because they are losing tiny amounts of energy called Hawking radiation. Let me explain in detail. According to his theory, Hawking radiation occurs because empty space or the vacuum is not really empty. It actually consists of particles and oppositely charged antiparticles constantly popping into and out of existence. In a normal state, when these virtual particles collide, they destroy each other shortly after appearing, preserving the total energy. But Hawking showed us that if a pair of such particles is created near a black hole, there is a chance that one of them will escape into space, while its partner will be pulled into the black hole. Over there, it will collide with another oppositely charged particle before it gets destroyed. And as the energy for this process comes from the black hole, so the black hole will slowly lose its energy and mass. And if the black hole does not compensate for this loss by absorbing additional energy and mass, it will gradually lose more and more particles and will eventually evaporate at a slower rate. But it would take much longer than the entire age of the universe for most black holes we know about to completely vanish. This means that they are here to stay for a really, really long time. Trivia time! Did you know, even if a black hole with the mass of our sun stops accumulating particles, it will take the 10th to the 67th power years to fully evaporate. And when a black hole reaches a mass of about 230 metric tons, it will have only one more second to live. Isn't it amazing, friends? If you want to know more about these massive holes, check our videos on the same topic. The links are in the description below. Hope you learned something new in today's episode. Until next time, it's me, Dr. Binox, zooming out.
Ah,
Never mind.